Good morning, class. So today we will be learning about the water cycle. Put a raise of hands. Anybody has heard about this lesson, the water cycle? Come on, what's the water cycle? In your own words.
The water cycle is where the water comes from and what it creates. Mm-hmm. And it comes from the sky and rain and naturally
make those vibrations. Okay. Any other ideas? So this lesson is intended to 6th grade students. We have an essential question. And the essential question says, so why is it essential for us humans to learn about the water cycle and its impact in our life? So you might think, oh, I'm gonna just learn about the water cycle because I'm in a science class. No, like the water cycle, just like any other stuff, is important to the earth and like how everything functions with the water. So the activity that we're gonna do in class. So we're basically gonna do a. Let me actually show you my home. So we're gonna do a 3D circle shape, basically about the water cycle. And once you start doing it, it doesn't have to come out like this because I did it like on me. Like, look, I went out my way to color everything, just to like have a demonstration for a class. So basically, it's a 3D circle shape. It was better, but I folded it when having it inside my bag and showing it to different classes. So basically, you're gonna glue it behind each other, and then it's supposed to like go around. It shows different vocabulary words, different activities that you could. So you could write the definition of vocabulary word. You could show different illustrations. So that's that. I'm gonna go around the class and hand you guys a piece of worksheet so you could cut with your scissors later. If you don't have enough, you go work in groups. So, you can have that one, you need to work on that, you need to work on that one. You took a work on this one. You took a work on this one. So this is the enduring understanding. This is basically, I'm showing you guys just a lesson, not the whole unit. But if we were to do a whole unit based on the water cycle, you have to do like different strategies to help you go work throughout the lesson. So the first one that I have is making side notes when you're reading. Do you guys know what is that? Making side notes on your readings?
Mm-hmm.
What is it?
Side notes is like jotting down important facts that you know about the story or passage.
Good job. And why is that important? When reading,
it's important because, like, if you want to go back and look to see where you find your information from, you have your notes.
Good job. So for the second bullet point, again, make notes on your readings. That way, as you said, look, once you go back, you can quickly identify the different types of processes that go up in the cycle. That way, you don't read the whole thing and you just track down the processes. When writing, make sure like you have clear evidence to support the claim that you're making. You could get that again from the notes that you just recently made. So that's for the enduring understanding. We don't really have to go deep in that because we're not making a unit. It's just a quick lesson to show you guys. Okay, this is the fun part. So these are the main vocabulary words. So condensation, who wants to read this one first?
Condensation is the change of the state of matter from the gas phase into the liquid phase, and is the reverse of vaporization.
Good job. Who wants to read evaporation?
Evaporation. Evaporation is a type of
vaporization
that occurs on the surface of a liquid as it changes into the gas phase.
Good job. Precipitation?
Precipitation is any product of the condensation of atmospheric water vapor that falls under gravitational pull from clouds.
Collection?
Collection. This is when water that falls from the clouds as rain, snow, hail, or sleet collects in oceans, rivers, lakes, and streams.
Come on, knock down the last two. So, collection. This is when the water that falls from the clouds as rain, snow, hail, sleet collects in the oceans, rivers, lakes, and streams. Runoff, there's actually three more. Runoff is when water is running off the land and surface. And for last, transpiration. Transpiration is the release of water from plants' leaves. So I'm gonna show you guys a YouTube video so it could better inform you. So is there's always different types of learning in class. People that like to read, learn from reading, learn from looking at visuals. Let me show you the YouTube video.
Hopefully it shows up.
It doesn't have a sound, but you don't need a sound for this. You just gotta see how every process works. So first you see the sun is heating up the water and that's already collecting on the land. So you see evaporation. You see evaporation is going up to the clouds. And now we're in the second process, condensation. So we will show hands. Who thinks looking at a video is, do you think it's beneficial in the lesson? Hi. Okay, guys. Okay, so I'm gonna show you a few diagrams of the different stages of the water cycle. That way you could get a better understanding. So here you first have precipitation when the water is coming down from the clouds. Collection, where the water is collecting in the ground surface. Then you have evaporation, when the water, the gases of the water rise up to the clouds. And then you have condensation again. These are different percentages of the water cycle with different illustrations. More different illustrations. Okay, now we get to the fun part. That's why you have your sheet in front of you. So I'm gonna read it out real quick. So I provided you guys with different, so in front of you, you have different sheets that with the scissors over there, you're gonna go around the circle, the edges, and cut it out. So once you cut it out, you're gonna fold this just the same way I did it. You're gonna fold the circle the same way, and as a group, since you have three here, two over there, three over there, and two here, as a group, you're just, with the glue, you're gonna connect them together. And then as a whole class, if we have time, we're gonna try to make this one the same way I have it. So who has condensation? Okay, so, well, I want you to do the illustration. I want you to tell me what would you place in the text area. Read me the first sentence.
Condensation is when a gas turns into a liquid.
Hey, you could grab a scissor from over there. Who has evaporation? Can you give the first sentence?
Evaporation is the process of changing a liquid into a gas by adding heat.
Hey, you could grab a scissor. Who has precipitation? Precipitation is any water that falls to the ground from the clouds is precipitation. You could grab a scissor from over there to cut it. Last collection. Read the first sentence. Do you want to read the first sentence? Here it is.
Collection is the water that falls off the clouds. In the form of precipitation, collects in clouds, lakes, streams, or soaks into the ground of the earth and becomes evaporation. This is the water that becomes evaporation.
Alright, thank you. Guys, if you have a scissor already, you can start cutting the surface. Who has this one? So read, what goes here? What stage is here? Who has this worksheet here?
Yeah.
What word goes here?
Condensation, separation, collection, and evaporation.
Alright, you can start cutting a circle. Who has this worksheet here? So let's start at number one. What goes here? What word goes here?
Accumulation, collection.
And the second one?
Evaporation.
And the third one?
Condensation.
Number four?
Precipitation.
Number five?
Condensation.
Okay, good. You could grab a scissor. Okay, you cut it out of it. So where's the circle here? So give me the first sentence. How are clouds formed?
Clouds are formed when water that before rises into the air and cools. When it cools, it condenses. These tiny droplets collect around the dust in the air.
Thank you. Who has the circle right here? Bring me the triangle for snow.
Snow forms when water droplets.
That's it?
I don't know how to say that word.
That's fine. You good? You can start cutting a circle. Okay, and I have this one, the final one. So for this one, you're like, so these last two, the sun and the water, they are important because, like we were to do a unit, like I told you guys, you would have to sit down, write a whole paragraph about it, but we're just doing a quick lesson. So for the sun, it says, the sun is the driving force in the water cycle. It provides the heat to cause the water to evaporate to start condensation. Without the sun, we would not have any more water because it will not be recycled through the water cycle. So basically what that means, what does that mean, what I just said? Anybody has an idea? I'll read the first sentence. The sun is the driving force in the water cycle.
The sun is one of the main sources for the water cycle.
And without the sun, there won't be any water cycle, right?
Or evaporation.
Correct. So now, if you started cutting your circle, remember, what was the second step after cutting your circle?
Fold it.
What was that? Fold it. So fold your circle in half where you see the line.
Okay.
The other way. The other way.
So look, you're supposed to fold your circle like this. It's okay if you don't see anything, that's fine. Because the next step is for you to glue it with your groups. That way, you're still not seeing anything. You're supposed to see the final product like once it opens up. See? So you have that one card, you have that one card. That's cool. You have your colors? You're supposed to work on Now, what you're supposed to do is grab your glue and take the first circle and put glue all around it. So just like that. Dry a little, and you could do the rest of them. You put glue on that one already?
No.
Okay.
What are you gonna stick it on to?
He's gonna stick it on right there, next to that one. Okay. Yeah.
Circle
and stick it next to hers.
Which way?
Just that one. Yeah, like that, and then she's gonna place hers on top of that. Yeah.
Once you have glue your circle and place it next to the other one, put your thumbs up. Okay, that roof is ready so far.
Oh, like it's turned around. Why is this one?
This group is ready. So we're still waiting for two more groups.
I need a blue.
Wait, so we don't need our notebooks? He did something too, just so you know.
Okay, this group is ready as well. So we can have just one full 3D circle for the whole class.
do it. You know, it's kind of weird.
She threw a bottle on my head. She threw a bottle. I was too short.
Scissors on your table, you can put them back. Once you guys are done, you can get back to your seats. Alright, so to recap everything we did, basically, this quick lesson is, the point of this lesson is for you to have fun. Kids, they always like using scissors, coloring, glue, and also learning. So, what's a better way to learn than also having fun? So once again, this is my work, the one I did at home, so I could present in my college and for you guys today. And this is the one we came up today in class that you all did together in groups, and then you don't have the strength that I have, but you get the idea. You see why I told you why to glue it on the blank sides? Because once you open it up, you're gonna have it all together. So to recap the lesson, who could raise their hand and tell me why is it important to learn about the water cycle?
One of the important things about the earth, like,
in what ways?
Without water, people don't survive and stuff. And like, it's important to learn about like where the water comes from, like what type of temperatures most water comes from.
Good. Anybody has any other ideas? Let's see if you remember. So what was one of the vocabulary words that we mentioned?
Evaporation.
What does evaporation mean?
The heat from the sun to the water.
Any other words?
Precipitation.
What does it mean? You want me to come back to you?
Goes up to the clouds and it will create
Let's go back and check the vocabulary words, because one thing that, so not just for this lesson but all the lessons, because once again, if we were to do a unit, you're gonna see these vocabulary words every day, because the way I plan to do this lesson, it will be for the final assignment. You're supposed to act it out that you're a water drop. So you're basically going through the water cycle, you will have to use these words, and like they are very important because they're these four main words, they're like they're what make the water cycle. So like you're supposed to know them. So let's go through them one more time. So condensation, anybody wants to read it? You go ahead. Now you see it right there.
Condensation is the change of state of matter from the gas phase into liquid phase, and it's reverse evaporation.
And that table, you have said evaporation or precipitation? What was the word you have mentioned before?
Precipitation.
You have it right here. You can read the definition.
Precipitation is any product of the condensation of atmosphere, water, vapor that falls under gravitational pull from clouds.
Okay, good job. So at last, I was telling you guys, basically write about a day in the life of a water drop, going through the entire water cycle. Include important vocabulary. So I need three students. Who volunteers? That's one, two, three. Okay, I'll start with you. So if you were a water drop, what would be the first thing you want to do throughout the water cycle?
Does
it
have to do with anything
with
either?
Whatever. Yeah. It has to do with the water cycle. So, like, what would you do if you were a water drop?
If I was a water drop.
It could be anything from the water cycle. You want to come back to you?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, if you were a water drop, what would you do throughout the water cycle?
I was a water drop. The first thing I would do in the water cycle is go through condensation, I think it is.
And what would you go through that first? That's fine. Go ahead.
If I were a water drop, I wouldn't go to evaporation first, cause I can get to hang out in the clouds.
Yeah, that's nice. You see the idea that he used, like, you could get creative with it, cause if we were to do the unit, you had to write out, use the vocabulary words, and what was one of the vocabulary words he used?
Evaporation.
And like, as being a water drop, how he wants to be part of the evaporation, but. So that's pretty much it for today. Thank you guys for everything. Have a nice day. Bye.
Bye. Bye.